Well, remember 70s rockers Dr. Hook? That had a stack of number ones from sweet ballads to rock anthems. Maybe this will jolt your memory. Locorriere is the voice of Dr. Hook and he joins us now live in studio.
Hi. Hey, everybody.
Hi.
I'm not supposed to say this to you, Dennis, but walk right in. Sit right
there. Thank you very much. They didn't tell me there was going to be choreography involved here.
We just love watching that montage. It just brings back so many great memories.
I know, it's except like, you know, show my baby pictures before I come out, and then I come out here, it's like, and now here's his dad.
You still have fabulous hair.
Thank you. Thanks very much.
Was it a bit of a walk down memory lane, though, to hear that music again?
Yeah. I've been out with a band. I just did a sellout tour of New Zealand, I'm happy to say, and have a great new band. And it's, you know, after Hook split up, I kind of walked away from it for a little while, and I did some solo albums and things, just because you want to know you can go forward. But now that this Timeless album is out and everything, it's really interesting. I meet people and I'm right in the middle of their lives. They come to me and they say, without even saying hello, they'll just say, oh, you know, I used to go camping and we used to sing your songs and my dad loved you. And I'm right in the middle of their lives, and it's something you can't really dismiss. So it's pretty cool.
The reviews have been fantastic as well. I was reading some stuff last night saying, you know, you've got everybody singing in the first, not that I'm surprised given the songs, but apparently everybody's singing along from the first song.
Yeah, no, it's wonderful. It really is because, you know, the album's called Timeless, but it takes 100 years to find out that it's timeless. Nobody's first album is called Timeless.
You were talking before about people growing up to the songs, and I did as well. My dad used to sing your songs. What is the weirdest thing that someone has done to a Dr. Hook song that you've found out about?
I probably don't know, actually. Wasn't there for the weirdest thing they've ever done. No, all sorts of things. I mean, you know, the nice thing about the shows now is that I see not only the parents, but the children are coming. So it's kind of recycled again, which is really good because it means I can come back a few years from now and everybody won't be dead.
Timeless, like you said. Dennis, where did the name Dr. Hook come from?
We were a bar band and we didn't have a name. And the Joe, the bartender, said we want to put a poster in the window. And so it was just kind of a guitar player made it up. We had a fellow with an eye patch. And so Dr. Hook and the Medicine Show. Not something I thought I'd be explaining 40 years later.
One of the big debates that's happening at the moment, there's news just breaking yesterday about, you know, Guns N' Roses have now been accused of plagiarising possibly Sweet, or lifting parts of Sweet Child of Mine from an Australian band called Australian Crawl. And it
comes, can we show you the clip? What do you think?
What, do we have it? This is the maraca solo.
Is that us?
Sweet Child of Mine.
The maraca solo.
The Little Nine maraca solo. Here we go.
You know, I don't know. I think there's a big difference between outright plagiarism and just what you've been influenced by a lot of times, you know? Because I remember writing songs and thinking, oh, does that sound too much like something else? But you don't do it to steal it. Sometimes it's just something you love or something that...
Well, I'm really worried that this new bout of sort of international litigation will mean there'll be no new music ever, because every time someone sees a dollar sign in a bass line here or a hook there or...
Well, in country music, if they start suing each other over the melodies, they're just be handing the money around. You know?
Are you worried about it as a musician?
No, I'm not really worried
about it. Have you ever had a song that's, you know, been maybe ripped off slightly and you thought, oh, that sounds kind of familiar?
Yes, actually, Shel Silverstein and I wrote a song called Michelangelo, and I can't really say the words. It was a little bit, it was about Shakespeare and it was about writers and why they do things and the hook, I'm going to try to be delicate here, was a little bit about that's what you do when you can't get no and it was a little rude. And then somebody cleaned it up and said, that's what you do when you can't get no loving. But it was a direct conceptual ripoff of the song.
Who was the band?
It was a group called Trick Pony or something. And to tell you the truth, it happened in Nashville, and it's such a songwriting community that they went from being like promising new artists to not heard of anymore.
So
they, well, they don't take that kindly in Nashville.
So you're frozen out of your own community.
Yeah, they don't take it kindly in Nashville. It's very much a songwriter's world. You know,
they became a one-trick pony.
That's exactly. How about that? How about that?
Over the years, you've been pretty controversial. There was that particular song cover of the Rolling Stone,
yes.
And what, it was banned by the BBC.
Yeah,
what
yeah.
What was that about?
Well, because it wasn't. It was banned because it was a brand name. Rolling Stone, and they thought we were selling it door to door. It was like, if you remember, the Kinks had a record called Lola,
yeah.
And Ray Davis's original line was just like Coca-Cola,
yes.
But they couldn't play it because it was a trademark, so we changed it to Cherry Cola.
Yeah.
But the cool thing about cover of Rolling Stone was I never heard it, but there was a phone number you could call to hear it, and I thought that was even cooler. How clandestine, you have to call a phone number to hear it. Yeah. Well, yeah, and there was the cover right there.
Are you still writing songs with brand names in them? I could use someone like that.
We'll talk.
I think getting banned by the BBC is a badge of honour, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, yeah. Well, I'll tell you what, this Timeless album came out, and last year I went to promote it, and they asked me if I would sing up on the BBC, and I wanted to sing the song Only 16. And because of things that have happened recently, they said, no, you can't sing that song on the BBC anymore, which was a little silly, I thought, because the song is sung from the perspective of someone who's 17. It's not supposed to be a 50-year-old man singing to a 16-year-old.
This is what happens when you last so long in the music.
Well, political correctness has gone...
Yeah, it's gone way over the top.
Way
over the
top, yeah. But everybody's frightened now of
things. Especially, I suppose, at the BBC.
Well, you know, it's not good to be frightened when you're trying to be creative either, because it stifles it an awful lot.
How lovely to have you on our couch.
Thank you
so much. Dr. Hook has a new album out called Timeless. You can also catch Dennis around the country. We'll put all of those details on our website.
Rock yes, on. I'll be back in the fall. I have a brilliant band, too. I can't wait for everybody to hear them. It's really, really cool. It was great in New Zealand. And we'll be back in the fall. We're doing about 15 dates everywhere.
Fantastic.
A lot of traveling.
Yay. That's what I like to see.